Hello world, though. This is Gemini, Wolfstar Gaming. It's Anton, and it's time for more Final Fantasy VII Rebirth. So, last time, we met Vincent Valentine in the bowels of Shinra Manor. And we fought his, as I like to call it, his beast mode. The beast within him, as it were. And my god, what a fight that is. I mean, I spoke my piece about it last time, but still, it's like, what a fight. Afterwards, we also had a fight against Roche again, which I was not expecting. I was expecting something to come of Roche, since we saw that cutscene with him being experimented on, I guess, by Hojo. So it's like, I knew when I saw that, I'm like, oh boy, something is gonna happen with Roche, and something did, and it was kind of sad, I have to admit. And I said that last time too, but I still want to reiterate it, kind of sad with Roche. And then I took some time and did some stuff around the map. I have, off screen, been trying to do this one piano song. If I can get the prompt up. I've been trying to do this one, the newest one that I've gotten, the, you know, two legs, nothing to it song on the piano. And I am really struggling with this song. I mean, I managed to get a B. I mean, I can't believe how high I managed to get it. I mean, 15,810. I am struggling to get back up to that score or higher. This is easily the hardest song so far, and I'm really worried for the sixth and final song, if I'm being honest. I don't know if I can get this one down. I mean, the slower parts to this song, I don't have too much trouble with. But when it gets to be like a bunch of notes on both wheels of notes, then my brain just kind of... I want to say it's because of my Asperger's. My brain just kind of shuts down because... if I'm inundated with too much, my brain just does that. And this song, with how many notes comes up in certain points of the song, my brain does that. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to get an A rank on this one. I mean, I'm going to keep trying off screen, but I don't honestly know if I'm going to be able to do it. So I just wanted to bring that up real quick. I spent like a couple of nights trying to do that song, and I'm kind of getting it down, but also at the same time kind of not. It's that hard for me. Even on the lowest note speed, we still have some more stuff to do on the map, as well as the quests. The two quests that are open. I imagine more are going to open up. I'm not entirely sure, but I imagine there will be more.
In response to last night's illegal broadcast by the SRC,
and then, of course, once I have all the divine intels, I have to fight Odin.
According to local legend, Odin's Zantetsken is capable of cleaving anything in two, be it the fabric of creation or the time between the seconds. You know, not to compare swords, but his might trump yours.
Well, thanks for the vote of confidence. It's like, what's with the trifecta of smashing things to get to the divine intels? Square, square, triangle, triangle, circle, X. Okay, I think I got that. There we go. That one wasn't as complicated. Didn't take me nearly as long as the first one either. What's this area here? I wonder if it may be for another one of the protorelic missions. I'm willing to bet it is. Oh, and you know, I completely forgot to bring up of the when I said that I was expecting either a one or of two possibilities of an enemy that we would fight in Shinra Manor as like a final boss of the area. And of course that wound up being, Vincent's Galleon Beast. But the other one was of like a mook enemy in the original that I could have really seen them do as a boss fight. This enemy that I'm thinking of is one where the enemy hangs from like this big, I want to say like kind of like a sickle. Oh, I can make a enhanced Yggdrasil armlet. But anyway, he can hang down from like a kind of this huge kind of sickle, like huge blade with a chain. For some reason, I can completely see that enemy being a boss fight. But they didn't have him. They didn't have him as a boss fight. Didn't even have him as a regular enemy. Oh, hello. Crank to open a gate. Yeah, I'm willing to bet this is where another protorelic mission is. I completely forgot to bring that up last time after, you know, the everything with Vincent and Roche. I wanted to make sure that I brought that up to explain, because I said that I would. I almost have everything made with the item transmuter stuff. I just have a dry ether and the expeditionary metal left to make. Oh, I still need to do the scenic spot. Get that real quick. That, yeah, like almost right by it. I think I see the sign. There we go. Oh yeah, this is a great view. A great view of a bunch of rock. There we go. Thanks for the photo op, guys. Oh, cache location. Nidhogg Grotto. One ruby. Two. 3,300 gil. Nice. Get out of the way, boxes. And a Valkyrian bangle. Gives you a lot of defense. I mean, and this is on Cloud. This one looks so big. Would give me an extra slot on Cloud. And these are all linked materia slots too. I'm putting this on Cloud. Oh, there we go. Ah. He's like, take me higher. Whoop. Higher, 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 higher. Ah. Hi. God damn it. This angle. Selena. There we go. Jeez. Stone Cold Spitter.
My sensors indicate the presence of a unique life form. Rare Disgorgon variant detected. Commencing guidance protocol. As the Disgorgon evolved,
okay, Disgorgon, huh?
Until it could no longer
give it all you
fly.
Got.
Stagger pressure in.
It began to produce a
time limit.
This toxin is found
assess. A suvite? Suvite? Disgorgon. A rare Disgorgon variant that secretes a variety of substances. Oh goody. From a debilitating venom to a self-empowering serum. Destroying its jaw when it uses petrifying mist. Okay, same thing as the regular Disgorgon. Weak to ice as well. Has a lesser resistance to fire as well, though. Huh.
A jaw, and can be stored in large quantities. It's created from the insects that form a staple of the Disgorgon's diet. The toxin's properties vary from species.
Keep it together.
You're in good hands now.
By the toxin that's consumed. This variant, for instance, is capable of paralyzing its prey. So
paralyzing its prey? What? Ah, I saw that coming.
Got you now.
Go on.
The power of his providence. How about you?
Here goes. It's your turn.
I got this.
I need to focus. Thrust. That triple slash. What am I doing? Focus thrust. Oh my god. Don't I? Yeah, I do. Take this.
Feeling chilly?
You got this under control.
Deal with that.
If you insist. Run like a chocobo?
I know you can do this.
You feet.
Come on.
Abracus, what's another?
Your strength is
stagger. There we go.
Ready for a smackdown? Quit screwing around.
Hey, you ready?
Leave it to me. Do it.
I'm your one-stop clobbering shop. This one's for you. You're gonna get what's coming.
All right. So it's my turn.
You can do it.
Let's do this.
Spectacular.
Here I go.
That's it.
There we go. Pressure there. Oh, come on.
Get lost! Get him!
Focus thrust again! Come on! I almost have him! There we go! Man, that was getting a little tight.
Congratulations! You managed to complete all intel objectives!
For a second there, I thought I wasn't gonna get him pressured.
Stellar performance, Cloud!
Thank you!
I can't thank you enough for providing such valuable combat intel. I'll use this data to further enhance my guidance functionality.
All right.
That would be a grave misuse of our resources.
Requesting attitude adjustment.
In any case, I've utilized the data for a new challenge. Feel free to access it via the combat simulator when you have the time.
Chthonian Rondu, it said? Are we getting, all Lovecraft? It sounds Lovecraftian anyway. This almost looks kind of like a gate here. Kind of. I want to be able to go through here. But of course I can't. It's even in this area. This looks like an arena. Last one.
It has been said that the land of the dead lies just beyond Mount Nibel. From this belief arises the conception of Odin as a gatekeeper of the afterlife, one who turns away all whose time has not yet come.
Circle, XX, square, square, triangle, triangle, circle. Okay, this one's more complicated. There we go. And that's the last one of that. Did I just see that his eye is red?
Be warned, Cloud. You have entered the King Zoo's domain. This is a highly dangerous fiend. Proceed with extreme caution.
All right. Thank you, Mai. There's boxes for me to destroy too. Yeah. These were like army barracks. You know, barricades. That's what I meant to say. Let's do it. Let's fight the King Zoo. Hi. Oh my god, it's like kind of looks a little like a Phoenix. Like all red. Assess. King Zoo, an avian creature with blocked blood red feathers that rules the skies above the Nibel region. Boasting excellent hunting skills, it descends on its prey with a mighty shriek. When it finishes performing its swan song, a single attack against it will deal lethal damage. Oh. Destroying its wings in the middle of its swan song will interrupt the attack and pressure it. Huh, alright. And weak to electricity. Also has lesser resistance to fire and wind. Alright.
A number.
Commencing
guidance. Oh, ah! Oh my god.
Majestic zoo earned such a lofty title. Zoos adhere to a strict pecking order, in which the largest male is one and only king.
Eat some Thundara! Ah! If I can get it off, he keeps using that windstorm. Or tornado, I guess.
Perhaps your efforts here will help us get to the bottom of this.
It's on you.
Wow, I almost feel sorry for that.
Oh my god. Zephyr poison? Is that what that says? Oh my god. Jesus.
This called for a
strike. I don't know how I did that.
Oh my god. Yep.
Yeah. You can do it.
Ah, come on. Focus thrust, right wing.
And say I'm surprised.
Oh, there we go.
Get lost.
Try this.
You know I'm cheering for you.
Oh my god.
I'm your one-stop club ring shop.
It's still a cloud.
Abraca's something or other.
Yeah, there we go.
Ouch! Ouch! Nice one. This one's for you.
Limit. UV.
Let's
do it. This is going really well.
Why don't you lead the
My
way?
Turn.
Get him!
Oh, come on! Firework blade.
Eric,
left wing.
Here it comes. Eric.
Cribble, left wing.
Are you okay?
Gotta be careful. Need a breather.
Here I go.
Oh my god.
Tell me, which way is it to Wutai?
It was going so well. I was trying to get to a healing spell. God damn.
With the power of his providence.
Oh my god, there we go. Jeez Louise. You have to defeat its wings really fast. Otherwise, Swan Song just wipes you the hell out. My god. I think that took me 3-4 tries, all told. My god.
Work dethroning the King Zoo.
Thank you.
Attempting to prey upon you proved his undoing, and without that winged terror flying around, the skies are clear once more. Those roped folks must be breathing a collective sigh of relief.
All right. Avian Tyrant done.
Uh-oh. It seems we've crossed into
Dagger, pressure, and within the limit.
Rare Nibel.
I got your note.
Higher Tail. A rare Nibel Wolf variant, its Azure Flame designates it as the pack leader. When threatened, it will howl to summon its pack, dealing enough damage while it is enshrouded in blue fire will quench the flames and pressure it. While it's enshrouded in blue fire. Okay. While it's not bathed in fire, dodging it or guarding against certain attacks will pressure it. Okay, while it's not bathed in fire, dodging or guarding. Okay.
Here he comes! One more shot!
It's on now.
Ready?
Thank you!
Get him!
Because I knew that was going to be the annoying one.
Now.
Is that it?
Enough.
While that was glorious, I can't give you full marks. Objectives yet remain. Well done. You've completed all combat assignments in Nibel. No doubt thanks to my quality guidance.
Or in spite of your excessive chatter. I need to adjust the speech frequency setting.
No! Stop him, Cloud! He's trying to silence me!
Anyway, thanks to your hard work, Cloud,
that's Harbingers.
I was able to devise another combat trial. I'm confident this one will pose quite a challenge.
All right. Oh, level 1 Nibel region intel. That worked. Wow.
I knew you had it in you. Way to go.
There's some carriages. I haven't been in this area. Like some kind of old settlement? I found a quest. Oh my god, is that Billy? Chocobo Sage Manor. Oh, is that Billy or is it someone else? I mean, it's dressed like Billy. I mean, I do have the Odin fight to do, so I could. Oh, a changing booth. I could change. I could change here if I wanted to. I could change into the swimsuits. I don't know if I want to do that though.
Oh, Cloud, have you come to brush up on your bird handling? As soon as I heard the legendary Chocobo Sage was here, I knew I had to come. I was surprised to see a recluse residing in such luxury. Even hermits enjoy a dip in the pool.
Of course they do, of course they do. I'm kind of a little scared to go up against Odin. of course, I'll do the other fights, the other Nibel fights off screen, because it's gonna be against enemies that I've already done before. Excuse me. Vitality spirit materia that has to work the same way that HP MP materia does. Oh my god. Another AP up material for doing this one, the Chthonian Rondo. Rondo, not Rondu. What do I get for level 1 Nibel region intel? Oh, time material, okay. And the Stony Stair. Ah, I get the enemy skill Gorgon Shield. And it's within the time limit. I just want to see who this is. Who this is up against, exactly. Who or what? It's a dragon, okay. It's against the Jabberwock. Okay. And I've fought the Jabberwock before. So yeah, I'll do this fight off screen. I won't do him right now. Let's try moderately weaker. I don't want to go straight to the weakest. Oh man. Odin, I'm kind of scared of you. Zoop! Right off the ability with right away off with an ability of his.
Too bad.
Odin. Oh. A noble summon recreated in virtual reality. This knight claims war and death as his domain, and atop his faithful steed Sleipnir, I think that's how you say it? And I think that's how Charlie pronounced it. He rides into battle and rends his foes asunder. Landing ATB commands, evading attacks, or inflicting detrimental status effects will put Odin on the back foot, both thrilling and pressuring him. Interesting. Conversely, taking too many of his attacks will leave him disheartened? What? Leading him to sound Jallarhorn's warning and unleash his Zentetsukun, excuse me. Jeez. I cannot speak, Zentetsukun. What am I saying? Oh my god. Whoa! And he doesn't have any weaknesses. I mean, he does have lesser resistances to, what was it, D-Brave, D-Faith, those abilities. Ow. Oh my god. Reprisal? Oh, jeez. I got heal on myself.
Here I go. You're going down. Ready? Now that was teamwork.
Whoa. I tried to get away. Oh my god. He's performing Zentetsukun. How bad is this gonna be?
We'll meet again. I know it.
Ooh. Damn. Oh my god. I only lasted a minute in. Just a little over a minute in. My god. Okay, I need to be fast with this. And I think I'm gonna need Tifa for this fight. And Sleipnir has a bunch of legs on him. Not four, eight. Eight.
Don't think you'll walk away from this!
Ow!
You watching? You're fine!
God. Gets to it so fast!
No. I thought I was stronger than this.
My God. How am I supposed to do this? Do I actually need to use detrimental status effects on him? I mean, he is... He does have lesser resistances to him. I mean, D-Protect, D-Shell, D-Brave, and D-Faith. I can't poison him. He has a greater resistance to that. What does it mean by both thrilling and pressuring him? Thrilling him? I'm confused by that. And I can't even survive long enough to get a Zented to use a synergy ability. And he deals so much damage here. Maybe that's what D-Brave, D-Faith, D-Shell, and D-Protect is for. Maybe. I'm not entirely sure. God damn. I think I need to look up a guide of how to do this, because this is ridiculous. Yeah, I'm doing this on my own time. I'm doing this one on my own time. I'm gonna have to. Because I'm not gonna sit here and try and do this fight over and over and over again. Even with a guide. To try and get this down, because it'll take me too long.
Found him. Where do you think these ones are off to?
I guess the protorelic.
But where exactly? It's like I feel like they'll just eventually take me to where I need to go, and that I don't actually need to push them. They just move so slow, it's gonna take a while.
I gotta say, this is really bumming me out.
What is?
These black robes. They all smell the same, more or less.
Because of the Mako, you think?
Could be, but I doubt it. Their scent is, I don't know, heavier? To me,
heavier.
A person's scent is one of their most defining features. But all these guys smell almost identical.
Hey. What do I smell like?
You smell like you. Simple as that.
And me? What?
Red has to think about it.
Do I smell like rotten eggs or something?
Yuffie. Rotten eggs. I'm sure you don't smell like rotten eggs. Come on, Yuffie. I don't know why I called her Yuffie again.
Following those guys. To wherever they lead. Oh, rogue guys, you must be cooking underneath those robes.
I feel like Yuffie's not wrong with that. Yeah.
All that black's gotta be stifling.
Yeah.
Oh, it is. Trust and believe. Hotter than a friggin' oven.
I still can't believe they managed to cross the desert in those getups. Pretty crazy.
Some did. Not all.
We ran into a bunch before you joined, Yuffie.
In Midgar? I saw my fair share when I was there, too. Never came across them before that, though. Now that I think about it.
Lived next to one for a bit.
Yeah! Back in the, first game. In Seventh Heaven. It's like at the inn, the hotel, motel, whatever you called it back in the first game. It's like Cloud was in the middle room between Tifa and the robed guy Marco. Okay, now I need to open the door. Door's locked.
What do you think they're pointing at?
There's a submarine dock beneath the harbor. Maybe that.
I bet you that's where we'll find the protorelic.
Oh, I see. Make us go and fish it out.
Okay.
The simplest way inside would be by sea.
Right.
And
makes
Selena's
sense.
Got us covered.
Yeah. Investigate the submarine dock. Is it that gate that I came across earlier? I think it is. Oh yeah, look at that. It's now busted open. Okay, so this is actually part of the map. Good. I was hoping so. Through the door. And there's a couple of rogue guys in here. What are these guys doing?
They're in here too?
I mean, before I do, anything for me in here at all? I gotta try Comet out. Boy, that's a long windup. Whoa!
Gonna pay. Get him.
Oh wow, that.
Just you watch.
Eats up a lot of MP, man. Back up here. It's like, where does this lead me? Uh-oh. More of these guys.
Stop!
Oh no! How dare you! There we are. Got another fragment.
Hey, Cloud?
Yeah?
These guys and Sephiroth are related somehow. Like, connected on some really weird, deep level. Right?
Seems so.
Seems so?
I don't have proof, just a hunch. But the more I see, the more I know I'm right.
Just one more reason why we gotta put a stop to that crazy bastard.
Yes. Most assuredly.
Oh!
Yuffie! It's like you should know that sound by now. It's Chadley!
I didn't mean to startle you. I simply wanted to inform you that I've located more rogued individuals.
Copy. Send us the coordinates.
Of course. Right away.
Yeah, this is kind of a weird one. Just kind of going around helping the rogue guys. River Mouth Mob? Helping the rogue guys and then fighting these cave stalker enemies. It's like, I don't quite understand this one. It's like, after a stellar phenomenon intel back in the Cosmo Canyon with all the remembrance with remembering Jesse, Biggs, and Wedge. I absolutely love that, but this I feel is like completely inferior to that one. It's like I thought they were getting like better and better, but this just isn't as good. I think this is the weakest one. It's not very interesting. It's kind of funny. I actually didn't wind up letting the guys in. I took like a side route. But yet, when I came over to here, they were already in here. That's kind of weird. I mean, I had to unlock the door. in order to... Wait. If I had to unlock the door, how did they get in? I'm confused. Tis a puzzlement, to quote the king and I.
There they are.
Alright. I think I know where these guys are gonna be going.
Wait. Something's not right.
What's wrong? Oh. Oh no. They're... Yeah, this again. Okay.
Shit.
Haven't fought these guys in a long time.
That it?
You good? I live for ready. I got you. Go on.
Come on.
You good?
Ready.
Ready?
Got it.
You good?
Ready.
Ready?
On it.
Gotcha. Come on.
Ready.
You good? Ready?
Bop, 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 bop.
Right.
Just...
Now come on. Run like a chocobo.
Come on.
Gotcha. Here I go.
Yeah. Help. There we go. Look. Boom.
Gonna pay. Got you now, little. Run that one, did ya?
There we go.
Got you right where I want ya. Come on.
That's that.
Inexorable end. There we go. A little overkill with the limit, but I had it, so why not use it?
What could his experiments be doing in a place like this?
Yeah.
Unless... No.
Yes?
Well now, this I did not expect. My precious specimens.
Hmm.
And you, Chadley.
Oh.
Model number CDA-6, was it? Or 7, perhaps?
Huh.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Aha. Yes, lucky number 7.
I see what they did there.
You and your brothers are just full of surprises, aren't you?
So there's more than one Chadley. Interesting. Now this has gotten more interesting. Now that Hojo's involved.
Don't be shy
in the
now.
Story.
Open up and let me see what makes you tick.
Oh no.
There's a good boy.
Oh.
What is it?
Nothing. I'm fine.
Look. Chadley, no, you're not.
It seems our roped friends are on the move again. You'd best follow closely behind.
Yeah.
I would hate for any of them to run afoul of one of Hojo's experiments. Please, keep them from harm.
Doing my best. Doing my best. Continue following the robe travelers. Wait for me, guys. I'm coming. I need to be your chaperone. I can't even push them along. Okay, I just have to follow them. They're so slow, though. And they're in single file. I want them each to be hitting themselves on the head. It's like, it's just making me think of Monty Python for some reason. Do I need to go up ahead? What do I need to do here? They've just kind of stopped. And I can't usher them along. Maybe I need to take care of the enemies? Come on, guys! What's wrong? Do I need to scout ahead or something?
Hey! That group from before, where'd they go?
Killed by fiends, maybe. Or forced to fuse with them.
Hojo's dead.
So you got any idea what's up here?
Old lighthouse, among other things. Never checked it out myself, though.
I wonder if there's a tea room.
A what?
A tea room. In Wutai, you can't throw a ninja star without hitting at least a couple, you know? Tea's always free. The food, on the other hand, that's how they get ya.
That's so. Well, I don't think we're gonna find one here. Or anywhere else nearby.
Ooh.
Oh, you vegan. Boo. It's like, so, you're so boring, Cloud. You're so boring. Okay, so, okay, hold R2 and L2. There we go. Let go. And again. And one more time for good luck. There we go.
We should go on ahead. Make sure it's safe.
Yeah. I agree. I mean, why not? Maelstrom, strike! Boom! That move is so much fun. Oh, I have three valves. Pay attention to the valves. Oh, pay attention to the valves. So they need to be in a certain alignment. Align the arrows with the colored part of the... of the wheel. Yeah. And then this will complete it. There we go.
Beastie, 12 o'clock.
Oh, hi. Oh, this enemy. Oh, my God.
I got your number.
Yeah! Sanguine Scourge. An aerial creature that has taken up residence in an abandoned lighthouse. Swallowing a piece of protorelic caused it to mutate. Really? Huh. That's kind of interesting. It utilizes an unknown energy to unleash devastating attacks. Inflicting enough damage will pressure it. Hitting its eye with physical attacks will deal a large amount of damage. Good to know. When its HP gets low, however, it will cast Mana Shield, rendering physical attacks ineffective. Gotcha. Oh my God. Rain of pain. Ow. Oh my God.
After you.
Here I go. Don't let me down.
I'll take care of him.
This one's for you.
Hey.
We have Barret in the background. Suck on this.
You, it's your turn.
Great.
There.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Not this time. Ow.
Here it comes. Let's be smart. It's on now.
Huh?
Oh my god. Ah!
Take the lead.
You're in good hands now.
And this is where, like, you...
Get lost! You need to chill.
Oh, no, 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 no.
This calls for a smite.
Yeah, there we go. Oh yeah. Maelstrom strike.
Gotcha. That'll learn him.
I'll take care of you.
Get him. That's it. Take that. How you like this? How about you?
Oh,
show
coming. Immune to magic now.
I got this.
Wait.
It's over. Keep it together.
You won't regret this.
Go on.
Ow.
Suck it.
Where's physical attacks? There we go. It's like I was casting magic on it. It was still saying immune. So I was like, why is it saying immune when I'm casting magic?
Did they multiply?
Oh my god. Yeah. For a second there, I was like, wait, we know that face, and yeah, it's Broden from Calm. Oh my god.
Broden? Broden, hey, snap out of it. Wait, the guy from Calm?
Yeah.
Is he Mako poisoned?
No, he's a former soldier.
He calls to me. I must answer.
It's like Yuffie wasn't with us at that point.
The reunion. It's time.
Now this is getting more
interesting. Do you think he was getting treatment in Nibelheim too?
Had to have been, right?
Cloud, I found another gathering of these individuals, the largest yet. It would appear that they're headed for the coastline. Do you think you could investigate for me?
Chadley, why do you sound so weird? You sound like you're in a tunnel.
Will do.
Is it Hojo's doing?
It's time. Time we checked it out.
I mean, it has to be. It was like, let's see what we can do with Chadley. Like, what the hell, man? Shoreline Shamblers. Alright. Well, this is... I spoke too soon. This has gotten way more interesting now that Hojo is involved. And, you know, seeing that we just saw Broden as a robed guy.
What in the... What are they doing?
Trying to cross the water. Come on.
Yeah... Let's... I feel like we need to stop them from doing that. Whee! Cloud?
Why?
I mean, they might make it.
Maybe. Guys are nothing if not tenacious.
Where are they even trying to go?
That island. That's where they're being called.
What?
Huh.
How do you know that?
I got a feeling is all.
That's good enough for me. Let's check it out.
And a bad feeling at that, right? Okay, well, it's like Selena's right behind me. What am I doing? Coming in for a landing.
So, you want us to go that way?
Which way? This way. Okay. So this is the same island. Yeah. This is the same island that I came to being like, there's nothing here. But of course now there is with the protorelic stuff going on. What the?
What are they?
Whoa. Did they just take down an enemy? A fiend? Whoa. My God. It's like, don't underestimate the rogue guys then, if that's the case. Oh, excuse you! And there's the other pieces. They took them from me! Whoa!
What is this?
Uh-oh. Now what?
Whoa! Hey!
Huh.
All yours.
Summoned by churls! How
churls?
Dare you! For this outrage, I demand satisfaction!
Alright! I mean, Satan stuff as before. Ah! He's gonna be tougher, isn't he? Okay, so... Did Sephiroth just... take the swordsman out of his dimension or something?
Come on, I will never.
Is that what happened? Whoa!
Let's turn up the grill.
Ah! Oh my God. Oh my God, what the heck?
I'll take care of them.
Get off of Yuffie!
Go on, I'll it's your turn.
Hang back.
Get
him! Oh,
yeah. Ow. Oh my god.
Don't overdo it.
You won't regret this. Yeah.
Gotta be careful.
Kind of, hey, go on. All right, I'll show you what I can do. Here it comes.
Oh my god.
This one's for you. Let's get serious.
He's definitely tougher. Oh my god. Ow.
My arsenal and all
its glory. Take the lead.
I'm your one-stop slaughtering shop. Oh, I felt that one, did ya?
I meant to do that.
Halcyon Descent.
Abracadabra.
I love that.
Coming to you.
Yeah.
What shall we pay you in pride?
Get him.
I'll rend your flesh and shatter your bones. Come on.
You're burning up.
I will cover all your limbs.
I'll
cleave you asunder!
Ah, 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 ah!
My arsenal, I got in all its glory!
Ah! Ah, god dang it! Aerith, come back to us!
Do me proud. I'll show you what I can do.
This might be it.
Is that it?
My turn.
Deal with that. If you insist.
Oh my god.
I'll rend your flesh and shatter your bones.
Got it now! Little...
Take this!
Bloodbath! Yeah, there we go! Yuffie for the win! That felt just kind of right. I mean, he... I swear... When we first met him, it looked like he was in Wutai. So, I feel like it's, like, made perfect sense to me to have, to keep Yuffie in my party for one, for this, and two, for Yuffie to defeat him.
Rousing, inspiring even. I must fight in earnest. Huh? Wait. No. It can't be! God found it!
Is he going back to his dimension?
The curtain has fallen, and I depart the stage.
All right. There's the protorelic. It's a breast shield, too.
Find me the black materia, Cloud.
Sephiroth will not let that go. Ow. and world intel complete for the Nibel region. Black Robes Protorelic. Professional Handler. Interesting that we had to fight the swordsman again, but this time not just as Cloud, but as everyone in my party. Okay. You'll get yours, you swine. Who is he talking about exactly? I really wonder.
You did it, Cloud. I commend you for collecting that proto-relic. At this rate, the remaining one will be in our possession in no time.
Right. Yeah. We have to find it. And soon.
Alright. Got the Black Robes Protorelic. And the final one that we have to get is back in Corel, because we couldn't finish that area off because of the Protorelic missions being... because of me being locked out of the Protorelic missions. Hi.
Huh? Cloud?
It is Billy. Esoteric Secrets of the Elders.
Billy? What are you doing out here?
I haven't had much luck at the racetrack lately. Not
sorry
the
to hear
good
that.
Kind, that's for sure. So I came here to train.
Train? Here?
You don't know where you are? This is the home of the Chocobo Sage, a living legend. Surely you've heard of the man.
This outfit. Oh my god. oh my god. I want this to be a thing in real life. A chocobo... what do you even call that? Robe? I guess it's... yeah. A chocobo robe. With a hood. Oh my god. I love it. Also, this guy's mustache is like... weird.
Did someone say living legend?
Calm down, Grandpa.
You okay, sir?
I am now. Thought I was a goner.
Huh?
Mind telling me who you are? I don't get many visitors out here in the boonies.
This is Cloud. He's a jockey for Gramps' ranch.
Oh, he is, huh?
That's
right. Billy here needs some help. You can pick up the poor boy's slack.
There's this big race at the saucer, the Gold Cup, and it's coming up soon. We gotta get in on that. So I came here to bone up. I'm learning all sorts of stuff.
Okay.
See?
Hey, tell me you're not buying this choco dung. Picking garbage choco out dung. Of a pool isn't training. It's manual labor. You see it too, right?
I mean, she's not wrong. What do you make of the situation? This man's not a sage. The sage is the real deal, or it is pretty weird. I mean... I'm kind of with Yuffie. It is pretty weird. And as far as the Chocobo Sage not actually being a sage, we don't know that for sure. So, it is pretty weird.
So weird. Come on, he's just jerking you around.
I suppose I haven't done much to pick up after him.
If you can flap your gums, you can move your gams. Now get on back to your training.
Sorry!
As for you, I know just the thing. One of my chocobos ran off when we put her out to pasture. Need you to
Selena?
Find her. Bring her back.
You're asking me?
Her name is Selena. Ain't your normal chocobo neither. Loves the ocean more than home. The way she makes rolling waves look like solid ground. No wonder she thinks she's the bee's knees.
Please, Cloud, would you mind? Just think of it as a favor for me? You've got a gift for wrangling the wild ones.
Yes, I do.
That runs on water? I already found him.
Yeah.
There you are, Selena. Well, I underestimated you. Takes real skill to tame this girl. Skills
it was
like
easy.
Those of... Hold on. I know this. I do. Why can't I remember? God damn it! This is gonna bother me all day. Oh. Aha! There we go. It was Sam and Will.
What?
Chocobo
they
Sam?
Were far and away my best disciples. As I was saying, you, Cloud, you may well become as talented a trainer as them one day.
Well, thank you.
Did I hear you right? Sam? You gotta tell me everything you know about him.
Calm down, Billy.
You're gonna give me whiplash, son.
The Sam guy you taught. You mean Chocobo Sam out of Midgar?
Has to be.
I do, but why do you want to know?
Because me and him, we got history. You see, I'm Will's son.
Well,
I was just kind of wondering. I mean, back in the grasslands when we first met Billy, he said something about that. And when the Chocobo Sage said Will, I'm like, Billy's dad? In my head? Question mark? Like, sure enough.
Don't that beat all? I'll never forget those two. They had such a powerful passion and an eagerness to learn, too. Everything they did was for the birds.
That's not the Sam I know. Sam's a demon. He led my parents to an early grave. Got them hooked on gambling. Pushed them to rack up tons of debt. And then...
That don't sound like him to me.
Yeah, I was just kind of thinking the same thing. I mean, we know him from the first game. We know what kind of person he is, but he didn't really come across as being, you know, cutthroat. I mean, he has a flair to him for sure, but not in that kind of way. He didn't seem like a wheeler and dealer who would take advantage of, you know, his, you know, closest allies, you know? So, with him and Billy's dad, I feel like Billy doesn't know the whole story. It's like Billy's only assuming what Chocobo Sam did. But he doesn't actually know. It's like, are we actually going to find out? I do kind of wonder that. I mean, we haven't seen Chocobo Sam at all in this game. So it just kind of makes me wonder.
You sure you ain't got your Sams mixed up? It's a common name, you know.
It is.
Only one Sam in this business. I swore that I'd humiliate him by winning the Gold Cup. Destroy his reputation. Then I'd at least have some kind of revenge for what that bastard did to my parents.
Now that that's out of your system, back to it.
Excuse me?
You heard me. Thought you came out here to learn about chocobos, not to get revenge. Cloud, for your next task, I'll need you to take Selena and gather choco grass, which so happens to grow above bodies of water.
I've been doing
you
that.
You kidding me? This fall
Russell's trying to get us to do his dirty work again?
How many of them do I need to get? Maybe I have enough already.
Shoko grass is a genuine panacea.
Oh.
I kid you not. It'll cure whatever ails you, and then some. And once I am cured, maybe I'll be inclined to share more stories about the good old days.
He's obviously full of it.
If not for him, then please do it for me. I need to know what happened to my dad.
I don't blame Billy for how he feels.
When I said it grows above water, I meant above. It's
called a
floating flower, because it grows in the air.
That's...
But with an ocean chocobo, you can harvest the stuff with ease. 30 tufts ought to do. Best
time
to do it, Cloud. You don't want my death on your hands, do you?
30 of them? How many do I have? I'm almost there, actually. I have 24. I just need 6 more. So this won't take very long.
I bet he was scheming against my dad ever since they were both apprentices.
Billy, you don't know the whole story.
Hey, since you seem to be in the know, give me the skinny. Who's the Sam guy?
Big shot in Wall Market.
Uh-huh. So he must be pretty scummy.
I don't know. For nail business aside, he didn't strike me as a total asshole.
Interesting. Or maybe your powers of perception weren't honed enough to see through his facade.
That's gotta be it.
Oh, if only I had found you sooner. I could have saved you from your own gullibility.
It's like, how exactly do these grow above water? Is it like the... It has to be like a combination of things, right? I mean, I want to say like part of it is like the moisture in the air from the water. I mean, that makes some sort of sense to me anyway.
That's a decent amount of choco grass, I suppose. Well, what do you think? Should we take it back to the stage?
Oh,
got him.
You get your hands on that choco grass.
I mean, we already know about them, so hand over all the choco grass.
Well, well, if it ain't my beloved choco grass. This stuff can be one hell of a hassle to gather. Thank goodness I had you to get it for me.
Okay, so what are you gonna do with it?
I suppose you've earned the right to know. First, I take this fluff, mix it with some chocobo feathers, and let it ferment. Once it's dry, I boil it all down. Then I squeeze it all out and voila, my patented choco tincture.
That's choco some kind of magic tincture? Medicine?
Oh no, just a little fun.
What?
Cheeky old.
You'll be
called out. Grass, if you've got some extra tufts on hand, would you mind sharing them with my assistant at the shop?
Of course.
I promise I'll make it worth your while.
Please, tell me about my father.
Hold your chocobo's son. There's still one thing you need to do for me first.
What a surprise. This geezer isn't gonna tell you jack. Face it, kid.
You got a lot of nerve, casting aspersions, after all the wisdom I've shared.
All the what now?
So you haven't realized you've been training this whole time? Tracking down Selena forced you to get in touch with a chocobo's feelings. And all that running across the water you did helped hone your sense of balance and your bird handling. Key skills for any aspiring jockey.
Makes
what do
sense
you say,
to me.
Cloud? Bet you feel like a real choco pro by now.
Can't say I do.
Sounds to me like you need more training. Reckon we ought to add one more item to your regimen.
Oh?
Think of it as a final trial of sorts.
Oh, give
final
me a break.
Final trial.
Don't go changing the subject here, Gramps. We're not doing your stupid trial.
No, it's fine. I'll do it.
Then it's settled. I'll be your opponent. And dear what? Selena will be your steed.
If Cloud wins, does that mean you'll finally tell me about my dad?
you've got a deal. But know that I won't be pulling any punches out there. When you're ready, give me a holler and we can hit the track.
All right. Discover Choco Grass Collector. All right. Huh. Well, before I do... Hi.
You got any Choco Grass for me? Now how about plumes?
All right. Oh. I can get a bunch of stuff from her. Or him, excuse me. Usually it's girls who sell me this stuff. I can get an otherworldly crystal. And cleansing material earrings. At 50 tufts. Ooh, I love the blue motif on these. Crafted from assorted pieces of reptilian anatomy. That's cool. It's like that. That's actually really cool looking. And it looks very, very Nordic. Very Nordic, which is perfect for this area. I really like this look. Really like this look. I mean, the Shinra Avian Graves are kind of close to the rest of this look. Anything upstairs for me? Yes, there is. Hello, blue materia. Level boost materia. God, I'm surprised at... Oh, and a chest. I'm surprised at how many level boost materials I get in this game. An elixir, thank you.
You prepared to undertake the final trial?
I sure am. Beat the Chocobo Sage, and I get a Chocobo armband in the process. Zoomed a Chocobo. Let's do it! I've already forgotten the controls. I've already forgotten the controls of doing this. Speed up X, circle to slow down, R2 to drift. Okay. Retry. It's been so long since I've done the Chocobo racing. I haven't been doing that off screen as much. I can't go between them. Fair enough. What the hell is in front of me? Oh my god. Retry. I'm doing so bad.
Thank you.
Oh my god, there we go. I feel like what really helped was the hat. Inspired by greatness. It helped me keep close to the Chocobo's edge. My god.
Took you a couple tries, I see.
Yeah.
Don't let a rough run or two make you question if you're cut out for this life. Bird handling is an art, one that requires hours of practice to perfect. So keep on keeping on. You'll get there someday.
A promise is a promise, sir. Please tell me more about my dad and Uncle Sam.
All right, then. What do you want to know?
When were they here?
Let's see. They couldn't have been much older than you are now. The two of them came and asked me to take them under my wing. Turned them down, seeing as I'd already retired. But they hung around the grounds anyway. Since they had nothing better to do, I put them to work. And that's how it all began.
What were they doing here?
Well, wasn't nothing out of the ordinary, I'd say. Ran some errands, did some repairs, helped around the house. You know, your standard training regimen. And in their downtime, they took it upon themselves to dig through my library, learning about chocobos and how to handle them. Came to differing conclusions. They used to argue something fierce.
What were the two of them like?
I can't say the two of them got on terribly well.
I figured.
Really?
Will and Sam had mighty strong opinions about how to best raise chocobos, and it drove them to fight with their words and with their fists. That said, only reason those two fought as hard as they did is because they both cared deeply about the cause. As far as passion is concerned, the two of them were birds of a feather.
Okay. Now we know more about them.
How you feel now? Managed to sort out the mess inside?
What do you mean?
When we first met, I saw the way your eyes were brimming with anger. I knew right then and there that what you needed wasn't teaching or training. What you needed was time.
Yeah.
Time to look deep inside yourself and clear out all the wickedness and spite that have been haunting your heart.
Which is why you had him clean out the pool?
Exactly. I don't know what happened to your father after he left this place. And I can understand why you'd want to beat old Sam in a race. Few things feel better than sticking it to someone who did you wrong. But that being said, you should never use your birds as tools for revenge. Ask yourself, why did I decide to start raising chocobos?
I guess it's because I saw how happy those birds made my mom and dad. How they'd smile. The chocobos brought us a lot of fun, and brought us together as a family. I guess that's why.
Good enough. The why is important, so don't forget yours. I reckon Sam's got his eyes on the gold cup. Keep yours unclouded by hatred, and you'll do fine.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for everything. I'm gonna head back to the saucer. Make sure our birds are ready for the big race.
All right.
Don't worry about putting your name in. I'll take care of it. All you need to do is show up and win.
Sounds good, Billy. Sounds good. All right.
No losing to anyone else, you hear? Can't have you dragging my good name through the mud.
Fair enough. Fair enough, old man.
Now that I have that choco grass, should start making some of that tincture.
You do that.
Thanks for everything.
I'm
gonna head back to the saucer. Make sure our birds are ready for the big race. Don't worry about putting your name in. I'll take care of it. All you need to do... There's still lots I'd like to know about my parents. Lots more I'd like to know about my Uncle Sam, too. Maybe winning that race will give me a chance to ask him myself.
There's the rub. there's the rub. Chocobo Sam is Billy's uncle. He has beef with his uncle. Oh my god. I love that. A chocobo, I guess, kind of mural on the bottom of the pool. That is really cool. And also, you know, pretty dang cute as well. Love it. Oh, I have two unreported, one for Cosmo Canyon and one for Nibel.
Hey there. Thank you for tracking down that spot. Quite the view you captured. Well, I'll be. You've come a long way, friend. My heartfelt congratulations. You've earned the master association's highest honor, which makes it official. You're a true master of the craft, a force of talent without peer. Said it before and I'll say it again. I saw your potential from the start. Though, if I'm being honest, I didn't think you had this much potential.
Well,
it's been an inspiration to see you come into your own. Glad I could be a part of your journey. Before you go, I made you this. A little something to commemorate our friendship. Wherever the road takes you, I hope you walk it camera in hand. The world deserves to see your art.
Well, thank you, Snaps.
So that's Cosmopolitan
Chic. High flying stamp. Nibel Nostalgia, Cosmopolitan Chic. Nibel Nostalgia is like near the same as what I have it normally. Cosmopolitan Chic is very blue. High flying stamp. Oh my god, that is so much fun. I love that stamp is flying on top of a... Is that supposed to be like the tiny Bronco or something? Maybe it is. And then a Cactuar in one corner and then a Moogle in the top left. Cute. This is a cute frame. Here it is, photo album. A scrapbook containing pictures of Cloud taken by the traveling photographer Snaps. Okay. Bring it back around here. The one that cracks me up the most is the pot one. Which reminded me of my... which, of course... reminded me of I'm a Little Teapot. It's too funny. I guess my journey with Snaps is done. That was the last one, I guess. My white-haired angel. Oh, it's with the singing head chef. in her kitchen. The darling little cat I feed from time to time hasn't come around for a while, and it's making me sick with worry. I know they can be independent souls, but she's never been one to turn down a good meal. Okay. Sounds like an interesting one.
Let's take a little
first
break
time
and try
in your house since right? I was, what, seven, eight?
Isn't really mine, though.
Not anymore. Hello, ma'am.
Hello, dear. May I help you?
Just listening. You've got a great voice.
Oh, you flatter me. I didn't even know I was doing it. You see, this cat I feed sometimes has gone missing. And when I worry, I cannot help. But sing.
It's like she just wants to be on the stage, doesn't she? It's like she feels like a, you know, a Broadway actress, the way she's singing. It's very, like, old-style Broadway. That's what it feels like, the way she's singing. I mean, before I brought up that her singing reminded me of Mama Cass, but now she's just making me think old-style Broadway musical.
Hey.
Hmm?
sounds like a job for a merc, doesn't it?
Right? What will you say? You sing often? Well, she just said that she doesn't, like, realize that she does it, but she obviously does. But I'm gonna choose this. You sing often?
Why, I sing whenever the mood strikes, really. Haven't you ever felt like bursting into song?
No, I can't say I have.
You've got an ear for music, though.
I played piano a little when I was younger. My mom
I was just
me.
Thinking that.
My, that's lovely. You ought to accompany me sometime.
Sure. I bet it'd be a lot of fun. Come on.
If you like, we can go look for your cat.
Really? Oh, what a relief. I'm Christine, by the way. Chef
Christine.
And chanteuse. You chanteuse? Might want to start by looking around the foot of Mount Nibel.
I don't know what a chanteuse is.
She's got the most beautiful snow-white coat. Petite little thing, too. Speaking of, she must be starving out there. Here, be sure to feed her.
Got a bowl of cat food. All right. It's like, where is she?
I'll leave you to find my darling cat while I cook up a mighty feast. Dum, 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 ba-da-da-da-da-da-dum.
Doom. I love that. It's like, gotta feel the music, right? Alright. Well, this is a quest. Gotta find the cat.
All this talk of cats makes me think of Fluffy.
Yeah, the one and only.
The one and
what
only.
What happened to her, anyway?
No idea. Haven't seen her since the fire 5 years ago.
Damn.
I can't shake the feeling that I just left her to die. I really hope she's okay, but if she's not...
I mean, she's probably a stray by now. I mean, her mom's gone. Her dad's gone. Tifa's been... away from home. So... Unless someone took her in, like maybe one of the kids here found her and took her in, maybe?
Hey, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
What?
How come you named your cat Fluffy? It's not like her fur was long or super soft or anything.
Well, to be fair, I wasn't the one who named her. The mayor gave her to me as a gift for my 12th birthday. When he put her in my arms, he said, "This little lady's name is Fluffy," but he never explained why. Don't get me wrong, I was dead set on giving her a better name. But before I could, everyone had already started calling her Fluffy. And the more I heard it, the more I thought, well, maybe it's not that bad. So I let it stick. I wasn't much of a fighter back in those days. Hard to believe looking at me now.
Looks like I just found the last chocobo stop. We just learned the backstory I never thought we would get. All about Fluffy. Oh, hey. Purple chest. Hello. Pair of crystal gloves. Even has an extra slot. Ooh. Very purpley. Makes me think of Purple Pain from the first game. Ability Unfettered Fury. I think this is a new ability. That doesn't sit... Yeah, I think so. This is not one she had in the first game. Gloves studded with gemstones that house magic power. Imbue your unbridled attacks with non-elemental magic. Ooh. Increases stagger. Proficiency bonus stagger an enemy with a standard attack while active. Okay. That's very specific. Stagger an enemy with a standard attack. So just a regular old punch. Enhanced techniques. increases damage dealt by unique abilities by 15%. Yes. That was a quick decision. Attack power plus 20. Enhanced elements. Increases damage added to attacks by elemental materia. With Tifa, I make her a powerhouse by putting a bunch of the purple materia on her. So, I don't think I'm ever going to use that. Max MP plus 3. Opening ATB bonus. Yes. And max MP plus 3 and limit break damage plus 10%. Very easy decisions there. Oh, and I just remembered. Oh, this is open here. And hi, I didn't even see you.
The reactor is off limits.
Okay.
The reactor is off limits.
Why? Because before, this was closed. And I needed Murasaki's ID card to access this terminal, but looks like it's already been accessed. I haven't even accessed this off-screen. Excuse me? Lifeblood Cannon. Consume all ATB charges and half your HP to fire a high-powered shot. Half my HP on Barret? Jesus. It's like, how strong is this ability? I wonder. Good lord. Yeah, I did a little rerouting with Yuffie's abilities. It's like, I decided to take off Ninja Bazooka and took off some of the stuff that I had up here so I could go along here. It's like, got United Refocus here, then Snow Flurry, then United Refocus here as well, and then up here for Mystic Multiplication. Aerith clones Yuffie, who launches a sprightly assault. This sounds like so much fun.
Hey, do you remember that red bandana Fluffy always had around her neck?
Now that you mention it.
Believe it or not, my dad made it. With cloth from one of his old shirts. Even though she was my cat, I think he took better care of her.
That right.
Sorry, didn't mean to bring him up.
No need to apologize.
What's up?
Oh.
Heard something.
Yeah.
Over there. Let's go.
Heard a kitty cat. We followed the cat.
Yes, I gotta.
Take the lead.
I got you.
Imbue your unbridled attacks with non-elemental
strength. Finish him off. Too late. Pour it on. Yeah. Bring it. Yeah. Get him.
Come on.
Gotcha. You watch it. Beat. Give him your arm. Don't bet you're gonna feel this one. That's it. Yeah. Enough. Come on. Keep it up. It's
all safe.
Wow, that was a quick weapon ability, Master. Wow. That was very fast. Very fast. I kind of feel like I should keep Tifa in my party for this quest, actually. I'm a coming, cat.
Kittens?
Oh. Good cat.
I can't believe it. Fluffy?
Huh.
Hey, girl. How you doing?
It's me, Tifa. Remember? You're okay. Thank God.
Aww. Aww.
Fluffy, what's wrong?
She doesn't look so good.
Let's try giving her the cat food.
Even though it was meant
came from, so dig in.
Wait. The cat we're looking for Christine is Fluffy. I just got that. But Christine doesn't know that her cat was Tifa's cat. Aw, right, Stretch. Good cat. Uh-oh.
Leave him alone.
Kittens took off running.
Okay, then.
And Fluffy has a health bar.
Bring it up.
Too bad.
SS Guard Bee. Guard Bee. Insects that mutated due to Mako exposure. They travel in swarms, bringing any prey they find back to their nest. Elemental weakness will pressure them. Fire.
Deal with that.
Okay, let's go. Go on. There.
And.
Come on.
Boom! Good kitty. Good Fluffy. Chase after Fluffy. Are we gonna have cat music? I want there to be cat music. We've had dog music, but not cat music. It's like, we need cat music. You know, nya. for the Japanese way of saying meow.
If this is what you want.
Don't overdo it.
I got this. Come on. Bingo, bring it. One more shot.
All right. Take.
Gotcha.
Yeah. G trap. Boom.
Go on.
All right. Good, Fluffy. Good girl. So much smaller to chase after than a dog. So it's like trying to keep up with them is actually easier. Where are you going? Oh my god. Queen Bee, a bean that rules over a multitude of children bees. She generally stays within the hive, but will come out to lead her children if she senses they are in danger. Her venom is particularly potent. And again, elemental weakness. No pressure.
Take the lead.
I'll watch yourself.
Hang back.
In that case, with fire, fireball blade. Missed. I wasn't trying to escape.
Keep it together.
I got this.
What? Small arena to fight in, man. Jeez.
Think fast.
Get him.
That's it.
Whatever.
Ha!
Boo, 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 boo. I have Blizzard on Tifa. Do have fire on Aerith though.
Come on! Ha. This is gonna hurt. Bring it. Yeah, it's over.
Ha. Ha, gotcha. Whatever. Ha.
You're fine. Bingo. Ha. Yeah.
Whoa, what is happening? Oh my god. Cloud. Heal yourself.
Oh,
there we go. Let's do it, Cloud.
Couldn't have gone any better.
I can help too.
Give it up.
Oh.
I'm a little worried Fluffy and the kittens might have been hurt. Do you mind if we head back to the village? You know,
of course.
If we asked her nicely, I bet that head chef would take care of the kittens. I mean, yeah. Can't say no to both of us, right?
Guess we'll see. Come on.
Oh my god, Fluffy took a lot of damage. Leading the lost cats. Stray too far from Fluffy and her kittens and they will lose their way. Keep track of them and stay close by as you lead them back to the village. Got it. Good kitty! Good kitty! Aww. I wish I had a cat again. I've mentioned it before in my Let's Plays that I grew up with cats. But... Oh. I had to cough, as I was saying. You know, while I grew up with cats, I love all animals. Okay, so I have to lead her, not her leading me. Come on, Fluffy. Come on. Good kitty. Come on. So I'm gonna hear the kittens meowing. Oh my goodness. It's like, I am now a cat herder. Cloud is now a cat herder. I don't mind this. I do not mind this at all. And you know, I miss having a pet in general. I mean, grew up with four cats. I did also had a rat. It's like I, of course, at the time, you know, 90s, I was huge into the Ninja Turtles, so I named him Splinter. It's like, it was only natural, right? We also, for a brief time, had a rabbit. The rabbit was my sister's. She had named him Ariel. Him. It was a male rabbit. And my sister decided to name him Ariel. I don't know why. It was an Easter present. Fitting, right? And also, for a brief time, we had a gerbil.
Careful up there. Fiends have started coming down the mountain.
Yeah, we also had a gerbil. His name was Nibbles because he loved to nibble on, he loved to nibble on empty rolls of toilet paper. He unfortunately met a very unfortunate end. I mean, we had put him outside for him to get some, you know, fresh air, and a dog came along and broke into his cage. Yeah. It's like we were very disheartened at that. Especially me being the youngest in my family at that. And I can't remember how old I was, but you know, I was pretty young when that happened. So I was pretty upset about that. It's like I loved Nibbles.
I feel so bad for these people.
I did nothing to deserve this. I hope I can help to make their lives.
Huh. Guess even she can tell this place is nothing like it used to be.
That's probably why she never came back here.
Probably.
What is it? Fluffy?
After him.
Was that the piano that we heard there? Very faintly?
Tattoos on their arms.
The song that she's playing.
Why, look who it is. Oh, my little baby! I'm so glad you're okay. And just look at all these yummy muffins you brought back with you.
Muffins.
She gave birth to her litter on the mountain.
Oh, sweetling. You're going to be a great mommy.
I hope this is all right. It wasn't exactly safe for a bunch of kittens. Couldn't just leave them, so...
Don't be silly, dear. You did the right thing. I'll take excellent care of this family. They'll want for nothing. Long I've dreamed of opening my home to little ones to play and romp and love. La 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 la. If I'm going to take these cats in, they're going to need names. You've got such beautiful white fur. Blanca. Yes, that fits perfectly, don't you think? As for the kittens, we'll decide later.
Actually, the cat's already got a name.
Cloud. No. Let Christine name her Blanca.
What? You weren't hoping to hear me play, were you? I'm terribly sorry, Blanca, but I'm a bit worn out after all that excitement.
Tifa can play.
Cloud? What a wonderful idea. You'll humor us, dear, won't you?
Okay. Just a bit.
Am I gonna get control of Tifa?
This occasion calls for an accompaniment. I know some folks who would just love the chance to perform. Don't go anywhere.
That escalated quickly. I wasn't expecting an audience. I haven't practiced since I was a kid. What should I do?
Back out?
Well, that's not an option.
Then I think you better get warmed up.
Oh, and there's my last sheet of music. Alright. Well, I don't know how well I'm gonna do with this, but yeah, I have to do this to finish the quest. Aerith's theme. Yes. Yes. I was hoping for Aerith's theme. Practice first. I'm so glad the last one is Aerith's theme, too. Ugh. Thank you, game. My wish is fulfilled. Oh my god. Ah. How did I miss those? I missed 46 times. God damn. I need to do this way. This way actually helps me a little bit. It still takes a little bit of doing to do it this way, too. I mean, trying to get the rhythm down. Get used to where the notes are. I did a little better. I did a little better. Thank you. Oh my god. Did I seriously just do that? And this was on the practice round. Oh my god. I can't believe I did that well. 12,800 for greats, 300 for good, only minus 120 for misses. I can't believe how well I did with that. Let's do this. I feel like I need to do it this way with it zoomed in. I already messed up. Damn it. God damn it. God damn it. Okay, this one I want to do well at, so I saved beforehand if things don't go as well. How was that? Rank B! The cat seemed happy. And I wanted to try it without zooming in. And honestly, I feel like I didn't do too badly. Would have been nice if I had gotten the A rank first try doing it this way, but I'm happy with a B. Cats are so cute.
That was lovely. How was it?
Much better than I remember, that's for sure.
Talk about a backhanded compliment. But I'll take
yeah,
it.
Yeah, really.
Thanks. Glad that you could help. Take care of the cats for me.
I certainly will. Rest assured, I'll keep them very well fed. So bring your appetites. All right, come along then.
So you
playing that piano again brought back a lot of memories.
I bet.
How Mom used to teach me while Dad was downstairs in the kitchen doing his best. Which was pretty good. Hangouts with Emilio and the gang. Which we kept inviting you to, but you never came.
Never? Really?
Really, but you seemed fine on your own.
That what it looked like? That I enjoyed being alone?
You didn't?
Of course not.
Huh. Figured not.
Guess we still don't know each other that well.
Hmm. Well?
Well, let's get to know each other right now. If you know what I mean.
Yeah, that's true. I'm glad we came.
Yeah. Glad we found Fluffy, too.
I think you mean Blanca. But yeah. I hope she and the kittens are happy here.
Yeah. I feel the same. Okay, she's not maxed out. Like, I still have just Red and Aerith maxed out. I imagine maybe if I had gotten like an A rank or with that performance, that Tifa, stop walking back and forth. Maybe a Cloud and Tifa's relationship would deepen even further. Maybe. I'm not entirely sure. But that's the quest's done. Interesting that there's only two here and not the normal five. That's everything done in Nibel / Nibelheim. So I think next time we will move on with the main story. And besides, I want to see if I go towards the main story, if it will lead me into straight into the Gold Saucer, or if we'll go to Corel first, and then maybe I can do a little bit on the map, because I do need to off screen. I go back to that underground fighting arena in the Corel region to do those final fights there. So I do wonder if when I go back there, if I'll just be thrust right into main story or not. If not, I'll have to see. But I want to make sure that I get those fights that I haven't done yet in that underground arena. Not to mention, I also need to go back to the Corel prison to do that Queen's Blood match against Wise. I still have that to do. That I'll do on screen, though, because, you know, that's another Queen's Blood match. And that one should give me another vision with Ladrell. For a second there, I blanked on his name. But that's what will happen next time. So, man, in terms of Nibel, you know, just right outside Nibelheim, not a whole lot to explore, unlike other regions. I mean, yeah, there's a Mount Nibel, that whole area, but it's not exactly an area that you get to explore like you do down here with doing all the intels. So I'd have to say that this is the smallest area in the game, if I'm being honest. So that kind of surprises me. Each area has been so big. Granted, I also did feel like Cosmo Canyon was kind of small, in comparison as well. I mean, sure, you had the, like, the whole dungeon of the Cave of the Gee, but the area of Cosmo Canyon, I felt, was pretty small as well. But this, but Nibel, I feel, is, like, even smaller. But, yeah, that's just my opinion. I mean, there, who knows, other people may have a different opinion than me. But, yeah, this is just me. So, I wanted to bring that up real quick before stopping. So, I hope you all enjoyed watching, and thank you all for watching as well. And if you enjoyed the video and want to see more, like, favorite, and claw that subscribe button to become part of the pack. And as always, everyone, I hope you all have a wonderful day or night, wherever you may be.